It's Christmas time. I'm the Vintage Collector, and these are my short Advent time stories. So we've been looking into alternate shells for Windows earlier on, so it's time to explore yet another one, which is Dashboard for Windows, a minimalist shell extension or replacement that could even coexist with Norton Desktop. Originally, Dashboard was developed by Hewlett Packard and launched in 1991. As opposed to its more feature-rich competitors Norton Desktop and PC Tools, it restrained itself from feature bloat, just providing this quick access-style dashboard window. The design itself seems somewhat reminiscent of the Motif toolkit that was the standard UI toolkit in many contemporary commercial Unix releases of the time, including HP Unix and SGI Xyrix. Whether coincidence or intentional, but there is somewhat of a resemblance here. One might even come to the conclusion Dashboard was developed with Unix users in mind to provide them some familiarity on the Windows environment. For certain is that the virtual desktop was clearly borrowed from the Unix world, and as it was state-of-the-art, you can easily drag and drop program windows between the virtual desktops. Dashboard provides you an easily accessible system resource monitor and full integration of the program groups, which can even be nested. As opposed to other solutions, it used a trick to make that work inside the native program manager as well. Let's inspect this nested group item here, which reveals the secret trick when you open up the properties. See how it's actually only a program launcher that simply points to a group file. It's so simple and yet so powerful to overcome program manager's inability to create nested groups by itself. But actually, Dashboard can fully replace Program Manager, as it's also incorporating the program groups, which you can even resynchronize via the configuration properties. Other than that, the initial release didn't provide too many bells and whistles, but still a fully configurable quick launch facility, or the option to have the dashboard always on top, and, of course, the extended screens. And while release 2.0, still under Hewlett Packard's reign, didn't look too different at first, it brought already some additional functionalities like detachable yet resizable toolbars or its own replacement for the Windows Task Manager. It was only then, by around 1993, that Dashboard was sold off from Hewlett Packard to Borland, which soon after re-released version 2.0, though aside from a refreshed setup program and a new included quick tool program, there was not so much difference here. What's important to note though is that the install program for either the version 2 releases but also the version 3 release are detecting when Dashboard is running as the Windows shell and asking you to restart, taking fully care to ensure a smooth upgrade experience. That was very nice. Now, version 3 was not released by Borland but yet another company called Starfish Software. Now the history goes like this, that obviously Borland's former co-founder and CEO Philippe Kahn stepped down from Borland and spun off Starfish Software. And when he did that, he took two products along from Borland, one being Dashboard and the other being the very famous Sidekick. Aside from an updated look, using the 3D COM controls as current by then, Dashboard 3.0 didn't add lots of fancy new features. There was these small games included on the dashboard, which thank God you could hide away, as personally I don't see how these would add anything useful. But maybe that's just me. The most notable and useful feature was certainly the inclusion of this taskbar, which replaced the default minified icon view of Windows 3.x. It's certainly a valuable addition, enabling you to do fast task switching in a similar way to how it was introduced with the Windows 95 taskbar at the time. But apart from that, I get the impression they were struggling already to extend Dashboard with new functionality, as, to be honest, the program had in my opinion already reached its feature peak and maturity with version 2.0. Why am I saying this? because here's Dashboard 95 intended to run on Windows 95. To me, it feels like an out-of-place concept here, which totally doesn't make sense any longer. Although to have the Quick Launch as a separate toolbar detached from the dashboard is nice, it is somewhat superfluous, as you could easily put your 3 or 4 favorite applications also directly into the top level of the by default always accessible Start menu. And it's also questionable why to have this taskbar, at least when running in parallel to Windows Explorer. Of course, you could still replace the Windows Explorer shell by Dashboard 95, although that would have been clearly against Microsoft's policy introduced with Windows 95, prohibiting software vendors to replace the default Windows shell. And see how the option to replace the Windows shell had actually disappeared from the Properties dialog. And while it claims to be designed to run on Windows NT 3.5.1, where some of these features actually make a lot more sense, it obviously doesn't play well when the shell technology preview is installed. It does, however, run just fine with the stock NT 3.5.1, where in this context Dashboard 95's own taskbar totally makes sense again, although not coming with some maybe not as well thought of overlaps where all these toolbars get in each other's way. Dashboard 95 to me looked like as it had seen its time by 1995, but certainly for Windows 3.1 this was a neat and powerful addition, especially for a lower end machine that would maybe become too much loaded with Norton Desktop or the PC tools. Still, Dashboard 3.0 could be seen as a valuable addition to the Norton Desktop if we consider it for two of its key features, the virtual desktops and the taskbar it brought along with version 3.0. I could certainly see this coexistence here. But what do you think about it? Let me know in the comments below. I'm the Vintage Collector and this was my story for today. Thanks for watching and see you again tomorrow.